Hey everyone, welcome back to cisolife. I'm Brian Hoagley, brought to you by SideChannel. And you can find us anywhere on social media using hashtag cisolife, or you can follow me direct down on Twitter and LinkedIn. And I wanted to continue the conversation based on a lot of the feedback I've heard, questions about how does ransomware work, what is exactly going on. So I wanted to give an explainer on a construct of a organization and how a ransomware group could be attacking, impacting, infiltrating that organization. So we're going to walk through a couple key areas to look at how to solidify and bolster your security posture right now on cisolife. Welcome back. All right. So we've got an IT department, okay, focusing on securing some type of an organization, all right? You've got some main data center, maybe it's AWS, you've got some cloud capabilities, you've got some home users who are working from wherever, okay? Now, this connectivity can be out to, the general cloud environment, all right? It could be to just your own private cloud, whatever. But for the most part, we're going to assume that your email is not hosted on-prem anymore, and it is now, you know, in some type of cloud solution. And that is, let's go with Office 365 or Gmail, okay? On the other side, you've got your bad guys, and your bad guys are doing something, and they're trying to figure out how to get into your organization. So let's take a look at what you're running. Okay, you've got some systems, you've got servers. Maybe you've got some of these that are publicly accessible on 443 and 80. Maybe you have some other type of services available on other ports. Don't know. You're running some type of web capability, some type of app. All right. Maybe you also have to allow these folks to connect in. You've got some type of a VPN. And that VPN has connectivity to the internet, right? That's how you can get up to allow remote access into your organization. So you've got a number of different ways that you're allowing people into your organization somehow. You're attached to the internet, right? And you're running cloud solutions. So this is what security is trying to take a look at. This is what asset inventorying is all about. This is why this is a big deal. This is a big component to figure out what are we running, because if we don't know that these are available online, if we don't know VPN connectivity, although if we don't know that, you're probably in a far, far greater trouble than looking at this video. We don't know what to defend, okay? So let's walk through how a ransomware could take place. So you have some bad guys, and bad guys have some cloud infrastructure that they're able to run around. They could be building out ransomware as a service, maybe just some software. Okay, maybe they're using an affiliates to also go after you, right? Now, here's what's going on. Maybe these affiliate groups, maybe the ransomware group directly, okay? Maybe they're starting to phish and send in phishing emails to your folks. You have somebody, all right, now this is just one way, but you have somebody, okay, now has unfortunately clicked on an email and given up their username and their password. And there's no MFA on your organization. They've given this up, okay. These bad guys now with your username and password are able to either log into your email, right? Now the bad guys are masquerading as you in your email, okay? They are now operating and able to read your email, get more information about your organization, pull that information over, learn a little bit more about you. Or what a lot of them are doing is they are pivoting into your VPN. Okay. And by pivoting into your VPN with this username and password, not protected by multi-factor authentication, This is where they are now able to infiltrate your organization. Is this into your data center? Okay. Is this into your cloud environment? But now the bad guys are inside of your organization, your infrastructure. And from here, it's just a matter of time to be able to identify what systems are operating and start taking down and ransomwareing systems. This is a standard playbook, okay? So, first and foremost, asset inventory, right? I can't defend what I don't know exists. If I don't understand that I have these areas in my environment open to the public and available, I can't defend it. Two, okay, let's protect what we have that we know is publicly accessible. VPN, remote access, publicly accessible applications, published applications to the internet, okay? Our email, okay? These are big blocks, but these are really important and these can be very impactful to your security posture in a positive way, okay? Third, multi-factor authentication. If I am phished and I give up my username and password and I'm using MFA, their ability to pivot into my VPN or my remote infrastructure becomes substantially less likely. I'm not saying impossible. There are, you know, ways to defeat MFA. I'll bet they are far and few between, but this now becomes a non-issue. So one concept, one way that this could happen, you could have other ones where the email is not a phishing attempt and it drops malware and then allows for remote access into this device. That becomes a little bit different of a problem that we'll go over another time. But here's one concept that I think is very straightforward and I want to say easy to defend, but allow you to start wrapping your head around how to protect yourself, right? Let's get an asset inventory of what we're running. Let's try to protect our exposed applications, such as our published applications, our web servers, our cloud infrastructure, our email, and let's enable MFA so that we are not relying solely on username and passwords for our protection. Hey, just an idea. Thought I'd put it out there. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Brian Hoagley. You can find me anywhere down on Twitter or on LinkedIn, or follow us around on hashtag CISOLife. And I'm somewhere in here on my lightboard. Definitely smash the subscribe button there on YouTube down below. I want to thank you all for watching. It's Brian Hoagley with SideChannel and CISOLife. Thanks.